Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? We are going to be taking a look at the Triad Pack for Team Fortress 2. It is a new update which added a few weapons, a few hats, a little bit of China, and it is all in promotion of the new game coming out, Sleeping Dogs. And the first weapon on the list that we're going to talk about is actually the most boring, which is why I've been letting it soak up a little bit of time in this intro here. And it's even interesting to say that this weapon is boring, because you are a heavy who is shooting out fire in all directions around him. That sounds pretty exciting if you ask me. When you look at the type of gameplay that this weapon encourages, it really boils down to you're going to want to stand next to a dispenser at all times if you want to get the most benefit out of this. Just for having your minigun deployed, you're going to be losing 6 ammo per second, even if you're not firing shots, and at that cost, you're going to be shooting the fire out around you in 360 degrees completely all the way around you at all times. You can't really be aggressive with this ring of fire, it isn't gigantic, so if you're going to try and walk at people, chances are you're going to be killing them with the minigun anyway. If you're killing one with the minigun anyway, what's the point? Well, the point really is, it is an automatic spy checker. It's going to be very difficult for spies to come up behind you and stab you and get away, because it's guaranteed they're going to get lit on fire. And if the spy is using the spicicle, they're not going to be able to stab you at all. But more importantly, if you stand next to an engineer's dispenser, next to a sentry, it's going to be incredibly difficult for the spy to get in there and actually sap the sentry dispenser, whatever he wants to go after, because there is fire everywhere. These clips are so boring because if nothing is happening, you're probably doing it right. You're keeping spies away from wherever you're trying to keep spies away from, so we're not seeing them. I can't really demonstrate that too well because there's nothing to demonstrate because they're not showing up to fight me because everything's on fire. So let's just jump right on to the next weapon, which in my opinion is the most exciting one. It is the most interesting. It is the Flying Guillotine for Scout. It is a secondary weapon. It is not a melee weapon. You might think it's a melee because it's a hatchet, and that's kind of like, I'm going to smack people in the face with this type of weapon, but no, this will replace your pistol. But you still throw it, kind of in the same way that you would throw Mad Milk from your secondary slot. And it hits people, it does damage, it does bleed damage after that, kind of the same way the Festive Wrap would do on a scout. But it is a secondary, and if you throw it at somebody who is stunned, it is a guaranteed critical hit, and I love this weapon because it is so stupid. There is no reason to use this. There is no point to this weapon. It does do good damage, and sometimes you will have a really good opportunity to do tons of damage to someone that you really wouldn't have had that option with before as a scout, but realistically, this is way harder than it should be to hit somebody with a guillotine, because you need to hit them with the Sandman first to stun them, and then you need to throw the guillotine. You need to hit both of those in succession to be able to get the crit. It's kinda awkward, but it's so much fun. And sometimes there's absolutely no point to it, where you'll stun someone, try and throw the guillotine, and you'll be like, you know, whatever, I can still run in here and just kill him with the shotgun anyway. I didn't need to go through all that extra work, I could've just used the scatter gun. The guillotine by itself, though, when you're not, you know, fishing for critical hits like that, on its own, I think it could be a pretty good secondary weapon, where it does have a interesting mechanic to it. There's nothing for Scout that really does this as a secondary that does damage when it's thrown like that. So if you have pretty good aim with this, you could really be running around with this and do quite a bit of work. I'm really excited about this one. It is day one of me still using it, and I know in the future I'm going to come to love this, get some better accuracy with it, and just run around and try and guillotine everybody. I know me. That's what I'm going to do. So moving on to the next item, which is the Red Tape Recorder. It is a replacement for the Sapper, and Valve only recently added a replacement slot for the Sapper, so now we're seeing the very first one added into Team Fortress 2. So what's kind of disappointing that the first one added is just so weird and kind of somewhat pointless. I'm just sort of standing next to the dispenser and checking out what happens, and it does de-level it. It was a level 3 dispenser, and over time it slowly unbuilds itself. But who really cares? Why not just use a regular sapper so instead of unbuilding itself, it just blows itself up? If an engineer is standing guard of his sentry, I guess you can get one level of building off of it rather than blowing up the whole thing, because it does do that a little bit faster, but even then it's kind of slow, and it just deletes itself from existence. I don't even think I got credit for getting rid of this dispenser, because it didn't technically blow up, it's just gone. I don't know, man. I don't know, this weapon's weird. So, we are moving on to the next weapon, the Neon Annihilator, and I had to go to the depths of Twofort, into the Black Lagoon, to try this thing out, because as a Pyro, you need to hit somebody who is wet to guarantee yourself a critical hit, and this weapon is, in fact, contending itself for the worst weapon in Team Fortress 2. It really just wants to be bad, and even lies to you. It says it does 100% critical damage, it doesn't say the weapon has any reduced damage, and yet you're going to notice the damage on all of these hits is 156, rather than what a regular critical melee would do, 195. It's really weird in a very funky way. It helps cover up a weakness the Pyro has, which a lot of weapons these days are doing, but this one is just bizarre. That's all that has to be said about that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like it if you did, and I'll catch you guys later for even more Team Fortress 2 goodness. Peace out, everybody.